deck. Let's see. Let's see.
Every time I move, his hair goes in my face.
You always get a hair like that all the time. Can we write some bags on this?
I think I can put some in the pockets. Let's see. It'll just look strong. You know that you always. Ooh, that is spooky.
Now give me a little motion.
To show you the world's only caveman. Goodness knows how he has escaped evolution for all these years, but for some reason he is here and he is living at Jasper Lodge, Ferris Road. Now we shall go and find him.
This is usually where he is. Ah, he's not here now, but look, it is a Mac. Very primitive indeed. Such a primitive operating system. Here you've got the main tower, and then you've got the monitor. And you can see the little Mac logo there. But where is the caveman himself? We shall find out. We have two dogs. And there he is. The world's only surviving caveman.
I don't want to put things in that are going to be a lot of work.
I'm sorry if that camera shot was disturbing for you people, but it had to be shown. There must be some sort of primitive idol he worships. I would now like to point out this could be very dangerous. Cavemen have been known to attack without provocation. To truly understand the caveman, we must delve deeper into his natural habitat. So, we'll go to what the caveman refers to as his room. He has over here. A very primitive analog alarm clock. The time displayed is not accurate. Oh, caveman keeps his CDs. Some of these are very old. I can see some classical music above, among these. Damn, that's old. And what's this? Is that Bob Dylan? Oh my god, it is.
Normal folks, dog how many food. Cavemen have you met that like to feed their dogs every day?
They usually feed their saber tooth.
Yes.
Okay, that was an interesting comment. Was not aware he was capable of humour.
Yeah. You're so unfunny, Paul.
Carrot.
Caveman seemed interested around my camera, attempting to feed it. Okay, hey, this is for Spam FWRD Chain Killer, whatever your name is. Whatever, I just can't spell the word forward. Because notice, well, maybe you have noticed, but there are vowels in the word forward, and you seem to have somehow removed them all. Also, when he sent me that email, he spelled writing with an E. And if you add ing on the end of a word, then take the E out, with the exception being B, because that would become Bing. This is not a grammar lesson. What I'm saying is that if people spam YouTube, that doesn't mean you have to go create an account which is dedicated to hating spam. Because you're just a bit obsessed, to be honest. And people can spam, and there's nothing you can do about it, so just get over it, alright? People are going to spam, and no one person can change that. If YouTube won't do something about it, then they will. But as far as I'm concerned, there's nothing really wrong with it. Because I know it might say that the girl will come out in the mirror and kill you, but everyone knows that ain't gonna happen. So there's no real danger to it.
Hey, diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle, the cow jumped over the moon. fun, and the dish ran away with the spoon. I drift out underwater to the land of my slumber, while the ark slides by overhead. And the animals sing to be in my dream, and the stars make a pillow for my head.
Shining through the branches of the old oak tree. Please let the light that shines on me shine on the one I love. Over the mountains, over the sea, back where my heart is longing to be. Please let the light that shines on me shine on the one I love. Sees me shining through the old oak tree. Please let the light that shines on me shine on the one I love. Over the mountains, over the sea, back where my heart is longing to be. Please let the light that shines on me shine on the one I love. I see the moon sees me shining through. The light that shines on me shine on the one I love. Over the mountains, over the sea, back where my heart is longing to be. Please let the light that shines on me shine.
On my travels, I ran into some strange map-reading cretins.
That's us. We're flag identifiers.
Здравствуйте, товарищ. Как у вас дела?
Ah, and one Russian wannabe.
Да.
I remember Zach as a 5-6-year-old in at Wallands in our huts out on the field. He was quite a character. He would nibble away at my pens and he'd end up with a rainbow face. I'm not sure if it was because my lessons were so boring or that he was just above the rest of us, which I think he was. And then he'd throw the residue outside the window. He'd also correct me on my spelling because he was a far better speller than me. It was lovely when Zach came back to Wallands as a young adult.
My name's Dave Waddle. I used to teach here at Wallands. I knew Zach both as a child and as an adult because he worked here as well. And one of my abiding memories of him was when a parent with a prospective student came round into the class. When we were moving classes, we had some packing crates at the back of the class, and Zach had climbed into one of them at exactly the time this parent was coming into the room. So I was just trying to decide in my head in that second of panic as to whether I should press down the top of the packing case and keep him in there whilst the parent was in for a minute or not. As it was, he just stuck his head out for that time that he was in.
Stephen Long, and I'd just like to say to Paul and Carol, you will always have our support and love, and what you gave to Zach over the years was obviously very special to him, and he knows that, and you did an amazing thing with Zach, and I thought what you wrote about him in the program you gave out today was captured it perfectly, and I know that he'll always be in your hearts, and Liz and I will always be here for you.
My son Martin got on very well with Zach, really liked him, didn't find him strange at all, had a good time with him. In fact, he said he's a lovely, lively lad. They looked at videos on YouTube together. They watched a very funny video about a guy with Tourette's, which they used to watch a few times, really liked it. They watched MASH together. He was into his hip-hop, and they enjoyed that. And says his thoughts are with Carol and also with Paul. And his final comment is what I said, that Zach was a lovely, lively lad, and I liked him.
Well, it's Roy here. Yeah, we'll miss Zach a hell of a lot. I mean, we enjoyed, as Steve was saying, the Scrabble evenings. Those amazing words he came up with. I thought he was spelling in American style just to fool us, but he wasn't. They were really there in the dictionary. Sorry, Zach, we miss you.
It's Lizzie Wright here speaking. My journey with Zach was one that took me into his invisible worlds, and I think that the choice he made for him was maybe the only choice he ever had. But I'd like to celebrate the way that you stood by him through his life, because I saw you do that with great honesty, and it wasn't always easy, but your love always shone through. Thanks a lot. It's Lizzie.
My name's Tim Freeman. I knew Zach as an adult. I'm good friends with his parents. Zach was becoming cool. That was one of the really annoying things about him deciding to go. You'd see him around town invariably with a cigarette hanging from his lips, which may not be cool in itself, you know, and his tatty leather jacket flopping along. And I was thinking at the time, gosh, you give it a few years, he's just going to be one of those cool Lewes guys that everyone's going to know. And unfortunately, he won't be now. But God bless you, Zach. See you soon.
Hi, I'm Julie Dixon. I never taught Zach. I think he came later into more of the juniors. But what I really remembered was Zach when he came back to work with us as an apprentice, and Zach coming out to all the social things and having a lovely time with us at St Mary's Hall and Dave Waddle's disco. So that's how I remember Zach, having a lovely time at the social things and helping us at school. Thank you.
Every time he walked along the street, he smiled sweetly to me. That's all I can think. And Yes, all my love goes out to Paul and Carol, a great friend, and we'll be there for you then.
Hi, I'm Martin. I was working with Zach, Zach was working with me when he was here as an apprentice. I mean, one of the biggest things I remember about Zach was just his mischievous sense of humour. Very intelligent young man, very good with the children, very good with the staff, better than me, if anything.
Well, we've known Paul and Carol for a few years now and seen Zach grow up, and I think my memories of Zach are him trudging past the house with the dog and a fag in his mouth. Going up for a quiet time up on the downs, where I think he probably did a lot of reflection and thinking, and I like to think that was kind of his happiest times up there. But always said to Paul and Carol is that he's probably, the way that he led his life, is probably in a happier place, and I think for them it's the start of a new period, a new chapter in their lives, really. And I wish them all the best for that.
Hello, this is Kate here. I just wanted to say a little message to our dear, dear friends, Paul and Carol. I find it hard to speak without crying when I see the lovely message you wrote on the back of the card. And I just want to hope that you feel surrounded with love.
Phoebe used to babysit for Zach. She started off having lessons with Carol on the piano and got to know Zach, and Zach and her hit it off, and she used to, a little bit older, she used to babysit for Zach. And we, you know, she'd come home and I'd say, what have you been doing with Zach? And she'd say, you know, cutting stuff up and watching it, video nasties. And I'd say, really? Is that okay? And she said, that's how Zach is. It's fine. And she was just like so happy and comfortable and loved him very much.
Okay, I'm Sue Eldridge, and I had the pleasure of Zach's company for 2 whole years in my class. And although obviously there were times when we had issues, I love him to bits. And I loved him when he was an adult and came to help in the school as well. And I will always, always have happy memories of Zach. Bless him.
Me and Zach had this inside joke where one day he had missed a week of school at Farney. And at this point, we weren't dating. We were just friends. Hardly knew each other. But when he came in, I was like, where have you been? And he went, oh, I flew all the way to Russia. And I went, what, on a plane? And he went, no, by myself, I can fly, didn't you know? Ever since, he was flyboy. And every time we saw each other, just walking past, we'd put up our arms and pretend they were wings. And then that became a bigger meaning, and in his leather's book, I wrote something very, very cheesy, along the lines of spread your wings, and things like that. But what I really want to say is Zach Manning was a great guy. And he was my best friend. I loved him.